Hello! Finding a list of virtual production tools and resources is not easy, but you've come to the right place. I'm Sean Foster, Director of 3D Digital Design at the Rochester Institute of Technology, and I'm going to be presenting today from an interactive mind map, which I'm going to share with you in the notes below. And the mind map is not only for sharing the resources, but it's also a context for getting feedback. So in the next month or two, I'm going to be looking through the comments and updating the mind map as we go. The mind map reflects that Epic Games' Unreal Engine has moved to the center of virtual production as a connector of accelerated tools and resources. And as I present, you're going to notice a bunch of arrows, and each arrow is a link to external resources. So that covers the intro. Let's jump right in. And the central link takes us to the Unreal Engine Virtual Production Hub. If you haven't already, you subscribe to their newsletter. If you scroll down, there's a growing number of companies participating in virtual production. And I've created a list with links to these companies that I'll show you where you can get access to later in the presentation. Scroll down a little bit more. Here is the core virtual production visualization. Now, this shows how virtual production really takes a lot of the visual effects process and filmmaking creativity and moved it from post-production to pre-production, and it's also turned it into a really iterative process. Let's scroll down a little bit. There's these two field guides that are available for download. I highly recommend grabbing those. They have tons of information about virtual production, all the roles involved, as well as like vocabulary sections. This just came out last month. There's the virtual production test drive, which is really great. And then as you scroll down further, there's just a growing number of resources that are updated as we go through time. All right, let's jump back. Let's talk about Unreal virtual production tools. Since this is such a rapidly moving set of technologies and workflows, I put the roadmap at the top. Let's click on it. I really keep my eye on this roadmap. It allows me to see what improvements are going to show up soon. Next, pre-visualization. A lot of virtual production comes from the field of pre-visualization. A Matt Workman CineTracer program is not only great, but it also illustrates a trend where Unreal is being used as the core to build new specialized tools on top of the platform itself for specialized workflows. And I'll show more of these tools that are being built later on in the presentation. And other examples of companies that have moved from pre-visualization to virtual production would be like The Third Floor, which started out doing pre-visualization for all the Marvel films, etc. Moving on, I especially like the Variant Manager for look development. Additionally, virtual scouting is being used a lot in pre-visualization for films. The rest of the elements on this list are connected to specific tools Unreal provides. You may have noticed some are colored orange. I marked the items orange that I felt were key starting points for jumping into virtual production. For example, next on the list is the sequencer. I made several recent videos showing different workflows, and I'm including a link to a whole chapter on getting started with the sequencer. Next, we'll talk about multi-user editing, and these workflows I think are going to be really critical as we move into the future, how we collaborate both in a localized environment as well as remotely. End display is a technology for multi-display rendering. Composure is a real-time compositing tool. I put a link in for a tutorial on that. Post-process volumes. Post-process volumes have been in Unreal for a while, but I specifically put in links towards some of the connective tools like OpenColor.io as well as the ACES standard that has been recently integrated. Optimization is also changing as we move into the realm of Unreal 5. Over the last year, there have been additional tools and resources that are important to be aware of. RVT, Runtime Virtual Texturing, is one, as well as some of the new world partition tools in Unreal 5. So let's move to audio. Unreal has just added a ton of additional audio tools as well. The convolution reverb is being highlighted. Metasounds in Unreal 5 as a whole tool set is something that looks really amazing. And finally, Live Link is a core technology that Unreal has built that will allow networked items to rapidly connect into Unreal. Okay, let's close this out.
let's jump to the virtual art department, also known as the VAD. The top item is organization, and I put that there because we are moving into a new level of complexity, both with software, hardware, as well as with teams. Organization is going to be more critical than ever. Naming conventions are probably the easiest to implement, and many have become a fairly standardized set, so I put a link to those. There are other paths which involve choices of tools like version control, USD, or Datasmith. Props and 3D sets are changing also. More, better, cheaper, faster. I already mentioned the new texturing technologies, but it's also just worth mentioning that if you're not using Quixel yet, the tens of thousands of free assets as well as materials, it's completely integrated into Unreal 5 with also emerging mega assemblies, completely accelerate as well as keep the quality of your workflows high. Not to mention all the high quality tools and assets available on the Unreal Marketplace. 3D sets. The tools available for 3D sets are better than ever. There's amazing new tools for sky atmospherics with volumetrics, tools for landmass, real-time water simulations. I already mentioned texture streaming and some of the new tools in Unreal 5 like chaos physics, as well as lumen for lighting and nanite for streaming geometry. One to keep your eye on, I think, is also AI-infused tools. Promethean AI illustrates some of the abilities in the near future for rapid layout. So I'd check them out. I'd also say volumetrics. Volumetrics and volume capture are something that I think in the next year or two, we're going to see a lot more integration into virtual production workflows. So some of those are worth keeping an eye on. Also, the cost of LiDAR has come way down. It's like built in on tablets. I'm going to be doing a LiDAR specific video in the near future. A core reason for virtual production acceleration is the ability to do VFX and compositing at speeds that were just unheard of a few years ago. The tight integration of the chaos physics as well as Niagara and material visual effects are completely transforming this part of the industry. Okay, let's move down to the smart stage volume. So lighting is a core element with the smart stage volume. You can grab IES profiles that are able to visualize the way you're going to set up your smart stage, as well as replicate inside of Unreal real lighting profiles. Also, I'm going to talk more in the hardware area about DMX as a technology that's been integrated as a core production-ready connection in Unreal. In terms of setup, there's been a lot of talk about the ILM brain bar, which is people who are live that sit in and drive a lot of the technical processes. I already mentioned audio. LED walls have become kind of a standard hallmark of virtual production, but there's still quite a bit of green screen work that's been being done. Put in links to PRG as well as links to specific processors that are being used to drive the LED walls, like the Helios processors. You can check those out, as well as some facilities examples. Epic Games has recently partnered with Nant Studios, so you might want to check them out. There's an announce link as well as just a link directly to Nant Studios, as well as another one that's really huge, Pixamundo. If you're just starting out, I think green screen is perfectly a great place to start. Or you could even start with miniatures. You could start with using End Display and a couple of just LED monitors. I think we're going to see a lot of additional types of integration in the near future. Specifically, I think there's a lot of opportunity for drone integration, not to mention the projection-based tools with different for domes or for lighting projections. There's some really interesting work that's been done with texture projections. And then finally, we'll see more MoCo or robotics-based integration in the near future. I've already worked on some of those. Okay, let's move over to hardware and crosstalk. There are multiple protocols, both with hardware and software, and a growing number of do-it-yourself or commercial solutions for professional video input and output. Now, the key ones are the AJ or Aja and Blackmagic. You can get professional video cards that will allow video input directly into your PC. Key element also, especially if you're doing LED walls, would be the need to get the right hardware for Genlock and FrameSync. So put a few links in for those. There's additional growing amounts of camera metadata that I think that we're going to be seeing more and more of that connected to, specifically for things like lens encoding. Then there's also new tools that are coming out The web remote control is, in the last several months, has just become extremely easy to implement, and I highly recommend trying that. You can have people setting up a virtual brain bar or specifically allowing control away from the PC stations for specific types of settings that you can throw to that. DMX and OSC are standards which have been around for a long time, and they allow Unreal, with the use of plugins, to communicate to different hardware technologies that are out there. Finally, if you are budget-oriented, there's a growing number of open-source methods and protocols. I just put in links for a few of them that might allow for lower-cost virtual production. Next, let's talk about tracking tools. At the heart of virtual production is the ability to get tracked camera movements instantaneously with real-time rendering technologies. So the virtual camera, and that's been solved in different ways. There's virtual camera that people have integrated directly into things like tablets and iPhones. So I put a link to that, as well as a growing number of professional level, complete all-in-one solutions. So I put in links to 8 of those. In addition, as I mentioned earlier, there's been a lot of do-it-yourself type work. One of the potentially obvious ones that springboards right off of virtual reality technology is using like the Vive tracker and attaching it to a camera. A lot of people have done that. I'm going to put some videos out in the near future that show some of those workflows. Okay, and finally, in terms of tracking tools and virtual production, there's a lot of use of different types of motion capture, both facial and body. And those all sort of connect now with the live link, which makes it a lot easier to put together. There's a growing list of mocap tools for both face and body. All right, let's wrap this up by ending in resources and news. Usually people come from different directions when they come into the field of virtual productions because it's such a convergent field. We have people who are engineers coming to virtual production, people who are shooters or VFX professionals, as well as people who are stemming from the Unreal area and then branching out into virtual production. One of the set of links, since I'm coming from the Unreal engine, I put a bunch of resources for getting up to speed. I also put links in to the 2 virtual production field guides that I mentioned that Epic put together. There's a virtual production Facebook group. There's also a link to the Unreal film and TV playlists on YouTube. There's a whole set of terminology that is connected to virtual production. Some of that I just grabbed from the first virtual production field guide, but then also having taught a recent course in it, I added a bunch of additional terminologies that we bumped into from the class. Here's a link to the virtual production companies list. I put in a Google search. Every once in a while, I click on this button just to see what new items are popping up in the Google search. Finally, keeping an eye on the Unreal Learning Portal, there's several courses now that you can take that will take you through different virtual production learning workflows. I'm putting a link into my YouTube channel. And finally, there's a growing number of events that have luminaries in the virtual production field talking. And I put one, the real-time conference is one of them that's had a lot of speakers. Epic has put on several, and I'll just add to this as we go along. So this can be a living document mind map, so you might check as we go along.
I'm going to take a deep breath and zoom out. This was quite a compile. I want to thank you for making it through, and also to everybody who gave me feedback and helped compiling this video, as well as Epic Games for their support. So if you liked the video, make sure you give it a like and subscribe for more weekly Unreal content.